Tonight we'll be talking about criminalizing marital rape in India. But before I get to the topic, I really want to know a bit about your journey.
Well, to understand what my journey is, it's for a woman, there is always a tipping point.
Right.
You think just a woman, she just one day she decides that she has to do something and she moves out? No.
Yes.
There is always something which asks her that, you know, she wants to do something ahead of this and she wants to create that journey.
A criminal psychologist, yes, in a country like India.
Yes.
How does that feel?
It feels great. Why? Because again, you can always feel that it's a woman in the man's world. So she's right. The one who's making a difference. And when you see this, that there is a woman's world making a difference, it meant a woman who believes that there has to be an equality and she's fighting from North Pole to South Pole. Actually, she should not be doing it because she's already equal. The equality where she's not feeling that she's equal is because of the monetary issue. Being in India and being a woman and into this crime field, it is not that I'm the only one. Kiran Bedi was also been there. There are many, many, many women you must have seen who has taken up this path. It's just this, that why it is important to let the other women know that we are strong. We know where we have our rights and how we can take those rights and take in a benefit of it. The only problem which we face in India is because of the laws which are pertaining related to the financial issues. And when there are financial issues which are being involved, which does not allow the women to be independent enough that she can leave her married life and can be divorced. Because still the patriarchal view in India would allow that woman to be stay in marriage and be safe. Because man or her guardian, that is a father, is the one who should be taking care of her. This is the way our constitution of India has been designed. So even with the children, senior citizens and women, that's the way the constitution of India has been designed. Now what happened is, if a woman wants to leave her marriage and moves out, and you have seen many divorces are happening.
Yes. Yes.
But what happens is, it is a very nasty affair. The divorces are very nasty. Why? Because people believe that the woman who has left her husband, you know, you will not point more of the fingers on the man itself, more of the fingers on the women. More of the fingers are on the women. You will talk about her character. You will you assassinate her parents. Yeah.
Call her gold digger.
I'm a lawyer, so I have these marital issues, cases in court. Believe me, there is not one single woman who's not been her character has not been assassinated. You know, she's been, her dignity has been robbed off in front of the court many times. But imagine the plight, the problem she undergoes. And over the more, if that woman, if we allow this case of marital rape, if it happens in India, and a person, and that first woman who will be going in the court, irrespective of talking about it, the first thing which she needs to do is filing an FIR, which is a major problem in India. You cannot file an FIR, making it into a criminal offense. Even if we have section 375 rape, but it is an exception where you can rape a girl of 15 years of age who is a wife, but below this it is a rape. But if she is a wife of 15 years of age and above, you can rape her. But the things have changed also. Recently, the Supreme Court has talked about it and they have criminalized this, like they have made it 18 years of age, even if your wife is 18 years of age. So they have taken this thing out. I was so thankful to that. This was a good news. If your wife is below 18, because they want to discontinue, or because it is already abolished, child marriage.
Yes.
15 is a child marriage. So this thing has already been abolished, and even Supreme Court stands with it. So they have done this and they have said that below 18 years, if you rape your wife, you will be charged.
Now, I feel that the awareness of women in marriages is lacking. So, when a woman is raped within a marriage, many a times she doesn't even probably know that that is, you know, sex without consent is actually rape. And unfortunately, the law also says that women who are raped in marriages have to resort to the Domestic Violence Act. Whereas domestic violence and rape are two very different things. Could you throw some light on,
I think you know that I filed a PIL in court. And because they all were criminalizing it, so what did I do? I took a different stand. What did I do? I took it into a civil thing. Remember that. Remember, my PIL came into the court as a civil defense. So yes. I said, okay, you don't want to criminalize it. What you require is first to criminalize it, you need an FIR.
Yes.
And a guts. And a guts for a woman to go to the police thana and tell that lady officer, listen, I am being raped. She will ask you, by whom?
Yes.
So you have to say that I am being raped by my husband. She will laugh. She will say, I pia kya? Something is wrong with you. Go back to your husband. Fight hua? Go, go, go. It's a compounding issue. Go. Compromise.
Right.
Okay, this is the first thing we are talking about. They do not know that FIR can be done on this thing. Rather, in domestic violence, DV Act. Now, DV Act has become non-gender. It was first for the protection of women related to domestic violence. But now, as people have started shouting, the men are also saying that we need to file also a cruelty case in the court. So, it became Domestic Violence Act. When we talk about women, we are talking about criminalization, we talk about things. Why? First and foremost thing is the central government, is the Union of India, because this is what we put our contentions in the court is against them. It's the political will. Now, if the men in the parliament or men sitting on the judiciary level, they will have to go back home. And what happened if their women only, their wives only, put a criminal case against them? How can you incriminate yourself by making a law? Makes sense? Now, marriage is an institution.
Yes.
Marriage is an institution. It means you're spoiling the institution.
Yeah.
Hindu law is a very auspicious and a very superstitious feeling.
Yes.
Once you get married, the dead body will come out. Many parents have said this to their daughters.
It's taught to in our Bollywood movies as well ki tum ja rahe ho ab tumhari tum ghar se tabhi niklogi jab tumhari arthi niklegi.
Sure. Yes. Yeah. So that has already been told to the girl who is not that smart. Smart means who is not been earning herself. Yes. And usually what happens is when there are two or three sisters are also there in the family, they can't take care of their, how many daughters they will take care of. So they want to shoo them off quickly so that they settle, she settle, that settles. The minute the girl comes home and she talks about, I want to get a divorce, it is a heart attack for the parents. How many parents ask their children to come back? Nobody. Yeah. Nobody. Yeah. It's very rare that people will ask now and on the pretext of sex. Imagine, do you know, they will have a major heart attack. Your parents, the old parents, they will say, you will kill me. How can you even put this question in front? Because the constitution of marriage is sex.
Yes.
And on this sex basis only, impotency, erectile dysfunctioning, which is happening in impotency, and then related to infidelity, and you can take a divorce.
Yeah.
So what I did was, I said, let's not make it criminalized as the parliament is not ready.
Right.
As the judiciary is not ready.
Yes.
Let's do one thing. Let's make it civil law.
Okay.
Let's make it a civil law. So that is why I brought this thing that should be done. If you cannot do it in criminal way, marital rape should be taken up in civil and let it become as one of the grounds to take a divorce. This was my contention. Let us take one of the grand, at least with this, we can file something in the court and we can take this thing as a ground and we can let it, how it can be sustained. But then there were many people who were talking about and they were saying, Anuja ji, it is always there in DV Act. 498 totally says physical, mental, emotional, sexual abuse. I said, how many of them has come up with a sexual abuse? How many women have come up categorically and without any fear and putting it in front of the FIR if it is criminalized or into the court by saying that I want to go away from this person because of the sexual problem? Because that sexual issue would not be sustaining in the code of law for a pretty long time. For that, you need many other things also. You need to, for sexually, we are also putting up, they put with 377 also, anal sex, sodomy. We're talking about that. But then only with sex, you cannot have divorce. There are grounds related to this properly.
How does one prove marital rape?
Now, this is the major thing when people say that, how does one prove that she is being raped? Now, when we talk about proving, even Nirbhaya could not prove that she was being raped. It was an open shut case. You understand that, right?
Yes.
7 years. 7 years, she has to explain herself. How many times a rape woman has to talk about this? Any rape victim? That can rape victim tell that in the court that she's been raped or not? Do you know that there were two finger tests which was now been abolished? And then they would think that if she has a mark on her body or not, so she's consensual. Mm-hmm. How do you put things? Mm-hmm. So even the woman who's been raped has to prove that she's been raped. Because in the end, the body, the medical legal certificate needs to be given up.
Yes. So that has happened before 48 hours or 72 hours. It's, I think, even report, medical report wise, you cannot prove it.
So what can be done? What can be done is, what I feel that what you can do is, if there can be, what I learned out from outside is restorative justice.
Right.
Restorative justice. Now, when we talk about restorative justice, we are talking about let a mediocre sit in between.
Okay.
And then, because this happens in child POCSO law, when the child is being raped by the relative or by the father or by the, there are times not in India, we talk about mother, but the pedophiles are there. So we're talking about those. So when a child, because this child does not want to leave the family and things, so then restorative justice comes up.
Okay.
It is very new to India. Now, can we use restorative justice along with the criminal law? We can do this. But again, look, start a dialogue at least.
Right.
At least start a dialogue. I'm not the one who's going to frame law. There are people who's going to sit pros and cons in how things can be done. Nothing is impossible. If there is a political will, if there is a particular political will and the people believe that they can, they should. They should bring this as a law. I have no inhibitions that it cannot be brought up.
If we legalize ethical porn in the country, most men would probably turn to porn.
It is, nothing has been, only the pawns which have been, I don't think so, that only those pawns have been unlegalized or been illegal where they have brutality in it. I see in India, it is related to, I don't think so, the ones which are normal sex, which they call it with different names. I'm sorry, I don't see that they are being, that the person can't watch. There are still there. But you, if you will not do this, rapes are already happening. They will take it out, their gratification somewhere else. Look, you can't stop that crime totally. I must say this. You can't stop a crime totally. I'm sorry, this will not happen. Crime and society, they both were born on the same day. So you can minimize something. You can do it with the situational crimes. Situational crime is you can take that thing out. But if you take that thing out, there will be a vacuum related to this. What will you replace it with? So right. think on this. And one major thing I just want to put it through in the last is difference between yeah. a will and a consent. You can always have a consent of a woman by coercion, by threat, yeah. by intoxication, yeah. by keeping another family on the gunpoint.
Yeah. yeah.
But you can never take her will.
Yes.
So this is one thing. Always remember this. The consent can be taken, but a will cannot.